Welcome to my review. If you are interested in the product, please see the link below the video description. As a parent, I believe there's a time and a place for electronic babysitters. While you shouldn't perpetually anesthetize your child in front of a glowing display, you should be able to cut yourself a break when stuck in gridlocked traffic on the expressway, and something like a kid-friendly tablet can help. Locked to Amazon's FreeTime service, Fire HD 10 Kids Edition provides you with a 0% chance that you'll look away and find that YouTube's algorithm has served your child neo-Nazi propaganda. Surrounded by a rubber case and protected by a 2-year warranty, this device is made well and reliable, just don't expect it to be much more. A cozy bundle. The Kids Edition is just the latest Fire HD 10 bundled with some child-friendly accessories and services. Unlike with the adult-friendly Amazon Kindle Kids Edition, there's a differential here from the standard tablet, and the big rubbery case has a super childish look that isn't suitable for adults, so this bundle is truly for kids. The case comes in blue, pink, or purple. It's so puffy, it actually bounces when dropped on a corner, and you have to access the tablet's buttons and ports through deep cutouts, which I don't love. The kickstand bends to pretty much any angle, and stays there. The extreme ruggedization has one Achilles heel: the tablet and case aren't waterproof, meaning no toka boca in the bath. The 2-year warranty doesn't explicitly cover water damage, but Amazon says it's a no questions asked policy. If you aren't familiar with the Fire HD 10, read our full review. It's a nicely built, inexpensive tablet that runs a customized, Android-based operating system that's heavily focused on consuming Amazon products and services. While it has Amazon's third-party app store, and it therefore does pretty well with alternate video streaming services, the whole interface is focused on making it easy to get to your Amazon books, music, videobooks, audiobooks and such. Spending your free time. The Kids Edition comes with Amazon's FreeTime Unlimited content service and integrates with Amazon's parental dashboard, which lets you monitor and control your child's usage of their devices and different types of content. For children under 10, and especially if you aren't looking for anything specific but just to entertain, Amazon's collection of books and games is pretty great. Its collection of TV and video isn't as compelling. The FreeTime interface is very simple, it's a carousel of apps, books, videos, and audiobooks. It's all about content consumption. This is a tablet to keep children occupied, not for them to primarily do their schoolwork on, although you can certainly kick it out of free time mode, and use the web browser to zip over to whatever sites they need for school. The tablet supports Bluetooth keyboards if your child needs to do their homework in Google Docs. In terms of books, the tablet does a great job of representing Amazon's relatively deep bench of picture books, as well as anything you buy in the Kindle store. For comics and graphic novels, you can get Comixology and Viz Manga, but not Marvel Unlimited through Amazon's App Store. You can sideload the Marvel Unlimited APK if you have an Android phone. If you're more interested in your kid reading chapter books, I suggest getting an Amazon Kindle Kids Edition instead, which is less expensive and more focused. There's a large quantity of kid-friendly games and software available for free through FreeTime Unlimited. I want to make sure to call out all of the Toca Boca games, more than a dozen of them, because they aren't free on other platforms, and because those things occupied my daughter for hours when she was younger. All of the apps in FreeTime Unlimited are special ad-free versions, too. In terms of videos, Amazon falls short because much of what kids want to watch is on Netflix, Hulu, or YouTube. The service does have SpongeBob, Charlie and Lola, and some LEGO-branded content, but then it starts to run dry of the most demanded video pretty quickly. That said, you can add the Netflix and Hulu apps to the tablet. You can also whitelist YouTube Kids, but honestly, there is no way to make YouTube truly child-safe for unsupervised use. There's just too much questionable content on that platform. Comparisons and conclusions. If you're looking for a tablet that will grow with your child, with powerful educational and creative apps, and that can double as a general-purpose computer. If you're mostly interested in the FreeTime Unlimited library of books and movies, that's available for iPad as well, although the games and software in FreeTime Unlimited aren't. If you're willing to step down to 8-inch tablets, Samsung's Galaxy Tab A Kids Edition and Alcatel's as yet unpriced Joy Tab Kids both combine basic Android tablets with libraries of kid-friendly content. We haven't reviewed those yet, but at first glance they appear to be more flexible outside of their kids' modes, but have a more limited selection of content in their libraries. You might also be trying to decide between this tablet and the Fire HD 8 Kids Edition. While in previous years I didn't think the jump to the 10-inch model was worth it, this time I do. The new 10-inch tablet has a significantly faster processor and more RAM, getting over any performance humps you might encounter on the smaller model. For a gadget that's largely designed to prevent children from whining, I think that's worth the extra money. The Fire HD 10 Kids Edition works as rugged, inexpensive backseat or couchside entertainment for small children. Don't discount that. I don't have a car, but Toca Boca apps saved both me and entire train cars worth of people during subway delays when my daughter was younger. That alone is worth something. Thank you for watching.